In a previous video, I discussed the difference between the command prompt and PowerShell in Windows. And if you've ever gone to use PowerShell, you may have noticed that there's a little message that it shows every time at the top and when you run it that says, install the latest PowerShell for new features and improvements. Now that new version they're talking about is PowerShell Core, it's sometimes called. Also, PowerShell 7 is the latest version number for it. And the names are kind of confusing, so that's one thing I'm gonna explain. Now, one thing you might be wondering is if they're pushing so hard for you to install this latest version, why don't they just update your version of PowerShell automatically and give you the latest version? That's another thing I'll explain. Now, before getting into everything, quickly, I want to mention that I'm not going to get into the super nitty-gritty details about all the differences between the two versions. I'm mostly going to stick to more higher-level major differences, and if you want to look up all the little details, I'll post a link for that in the description and mention it later. All right, so now let's get into the seemingly different versions of PowerShell. So you may have heard several terms. You may have heard Windows PowerShell, or also PowerShell Core. I already mentioned that myself. Also, just PowerShell. And the important thing to understand is all of these do refer to the same piece of software. It's all PowerShell, just different versions of it, different stages of development, and there is a reason for them having different names, which I'll go over. So like I touched on, PowerShell is the general term for the software. So it's sort of like saying iOS or Android. You might be talking about a specific version like iOS 16 or Android 10, but you can also just be referring to the whole thing. And at the moment, there are 7 different major versions of PowerShell, the latest being PowerShell 7. Now, as you know, Windows includes PowerShell when you install it. It's pre-installed. And what you might not have noticed, though you can tell me, is if you go to run PowerShell, it says Windows PowerShell. It doesn't just say PowerShell. And you might think, what's the difference? Is there? Well, yes, there is a difference, and it is significant. You see, PowerShell is not just included with Windows. It is its own piece of software. If you went to the GitHub page where Microsoft posts the source code for the new PowerShell, you can go and download it and install it onto your computer. But if you do go to install it, it will just show up as PowerShell, not Windows PowerShell. Windows PowerShell specifically refers to the install that came with Windows. It's considered a component of your Windows installation. Now, Windows PowerShell is the same software as PowerShell. It's just an older version. It's a more stable version that Microsoft decided, okay, with Windows 10, for example, we're going to include this version of PowerShell, in this case, version 5.1 is what's included with Windows 10 and Windows 11. So if you're running Windows PowerShell, it is just PowerShell 5.1, and that's included with Windows, so they call it Windows PowerShell. But the important thing to know is it's not going to be the very latest version of PowerShell, unless in the future there's a brand new version of Windows and they decide to include the latest major version of PowerShell, but at the moment, that's not the case. But why is this? Why keep this separate older version of PowerShell in Windows that you never add features to and still promote this newer version of PowerShell? Why even keep this difference up? Well, imagine you're a very big company and you're running some old version of Windows like XP, God forbid, and you decide, all right, you know what? We're finally gonna bite the bullet and just upgrade all our systems to Windows 11. We're gonna rewrite our entire infrastructure around Windows, and that's going to include a lot of PowerShell scripts. So when we deploy new computers, it's going to use a PowerShell script to install all the software, and we're also going to teach all of our IT admins the different commands and configurations we want to use, and we're going to use PowerShell to do that. And in such a real scenario, it's likely that the company does not exactly care about having all the latest nice features. They are going to absolutely prioritize the stuff just continuing to work. If you're putting all these resources into creating scripts and teaching your IT how to use PowerShell on this particular version, and then Microsoft goes and creates multiple updates for PowerShell, that's all these new major versions that change things and may break things, well then, that's not very appealing if every few years you're gonna have to rewrite all your scripts and you don't really have a choice in it. So instead, when Microsoft goes to release a major version of Windows, like Windows 11, they'll say, okay, you know what? We're gonna release PowerShell 5.1 along with Windows and build it in. And then we're also going to support that specific version of PowerShell as long as we support Windows 11, because we're gonna include it as a component. And of course, Microsoft is going to continue to develop PowerShell and add features for the future, and they'll release that as its own separate software. For people who do happen to want to have the latest version with the latest features, they can choose to go and install that themselves. And again, it will be alongside Windows PowerShell, which will stay the same. But the important thing is, even though they're not going to be adding new features or upgrading anything major, well, they're still going to support it in terms of creating bug fixes and security updates. So that way, companies that invest a bunch of resources into creating an infrastructure around this version of PowerShell, they know that they can keep doing that because Microsoft will keep supporting it, and they don't have to use the newer version that might not work with what they make. All right, so now we can get into what the heck PowerShell Core is. So the first thing you need to understand is that all the way up to PowerShell version 5, it was written on a software framework called the .NET framework. And just think of this like the underlying architecture of the software. Not going to get into too many more details than that. But starting with PowerShell 6, Microsoft rewrote PowerShell in a new framework or architecture, which was .NET Core. And it's actually technically a subset of the .NET framework, but not going to get into that. It's a new architecture, just think of it that way. And there were several improvements. One very notable one is that where PowerShell before could only run on Windows, now PowerShell 6 and forward, aka PowerShell Core, because they run on .NET Core, those are actually able to run and be installed on not just Windows, but also Linux and macOS as well. So now PowerShell is completely cross-platform, and also Microsoft decided to make PowerShell Core open source. So you can go and look at the source code on GitHub if you wanted to. Now, when Microsoft went to release PowerShell 6, they decided, all right, behind the scenes, there are enough major differences with this and also enough compatibility differences. Some things don't exactly work as they used to with PowerShell 5. We better add something to the name to signify it's a little bit different. So they decided to call it PowerShell Core 6 because it's written on the .core framework. So basically just to let people know that this is more than a typical version update. However, all that being said, when they released PowerShell 7, they decided to just drop the core naming scheme and just call it PowerShell again. Or if you want to include the version name, just PowerShell 7. And a big part of that is when they went from 6 to 7, they improved a lot of the compatibility issues. So it was a lot easier to get stuff that you were doing on 5 to work with 7, though there are some differences. So I guess they figured, all right, it's close enough. We'll just call it PowerShell again. And just to be totally clear, it's not like versions 6 and 7 had a non-core version. When they went from version 5 to 6, they completely changed PowerShell to be on the .core framework. It's not like they had two parallel versions. So in summary, PowerShell Core is just an alternative name you can use to refer to versions of PowerShell that are written on the .core framework, which are, at the moment, 6 and 7, and also anything going forward. Now, another thing I want to talk about, because you may have also seen this, if you've ever gone to type in PowerShell into the start menu, you may have seen a result for something called Windows PowerShell ISE come up. And if you open it up, you can see it has a bunch of these commands on the right-hand side, and on the left, it's like this window where you can type in a bunch of text, and below it, it looks like a regular PowerShell window. What is all this about? Well, like you might know, and how I discussed in my other video, PowerShell is not just the name of the command prompt-like program. It's actually also the name of an entire scripting language. So you could write a program in PowerShell. So just like you might write a program in Python or some other programming language, you can write it in PowerShell. And then it runs in the PowerShell program, but it's also written in the PowerShell language. Anyway, because you might be writing scripts that are many, many lines long, not just typing in individual commands, they created the PowerShell ISE, Integrated Scripting Environment, which basically just gives you a larger space where you can type in and create a whole script and also run it as a whole instead of having to do something silly like putting each individual line of the script into PowerShell to test it out and running it individually. You can just literally run the whole thing at once, also debug the script. It's very similar to an IDE, Integrated Development Environment, for other programs. Though, one thing to mention is the PowerShell ISE is only included with the Windows PowerShell, so installed with Windows. If you go to download PowerShell Core, latest version of PowerShell, it's not going to include a PowerShell Core ISE. It's only the one with Windows that has that. Why is that? I don't know. So some final thoughts. Should you actually install this latest version of PowerShell they keep telling you to? I mean, yeah, you may as well. There's not really a reason not to. There are plenty of additional features, and like I said, it's under active development, so there will continue to be new features. For example, some of the ones listed on the Microsoft article about this, it's cross-platform. We already talked about that. It has improved performance. There's new commandlets, which are basically just like a little bit more advanced commands. I talked about that in the other video. And there's new features with the language itself, so new ways to do different comparisons or whatever. But there are also plenty of other differences, including ones that may make it not compatible if you were to try to run certain scripts in older versions of PowerShell. For example, many commandlets and modules were removed. Also, because this is cross-platform, there are some scripts that you might run on Windows that might not work on another computer, obviously, if it was like Mac OS or Linux. There's also a whole bunch of other little technical differences that I'm not qualified to explain, so I'll put that link in the description if you want to see the exact article that talks about literally all the differences if you are familiar with that stuff. But hopefully this video still informed you. Maybe you didn't even know about this new version of PowerShell, but now you do and you decide, hey, I want to get that too. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to smash the like button so hard that you literally put your hand through the monitor. And if you want to keep watching, the next video I'd recommend is that one that I mentioned at the beginning talking about the differences between regular command prompt and PowerShell. I went into quite a bit more differences in general, not just PowerShell Core, so you can click on that right there. So thanks so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next video.